Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Democrats are beside themselves over President Trump having the chance to nominate yet another Supreme Court justice. Gorsuch was bad enough, but now, Trump is filling Kennedy's seat. He was the moderate swing vote on the court. And the leading contenders for Trump's selection are all constitutional conservatives who are pro-life. Bummer for the left. And all of this is due to Obama's arrogance. It is just now dawning on Democrats that the Obama White House is to blame for all of this. They may be furious that Trump gets to shape the Supreme Court for decades to come and cementing a conservative majority for the foreseeable future, but they only have themselves and Obama to blame here. The left thinks that Trump convinced Justice Anthony Kennedy to retire so he could fill his seat. There may be some truth to that, but not the way the left thinks. I understand that Kennedy went to see President Trump before his announcement to tell him he has faith in him picking a suitable successor. The left calls it dirty pool, I call it nuance. It was a calculated move on Kennedy's part and very prudent if you ask me. He's 81 now and it is time to let younger blood put on the black robe. Kennedy was not manipulated, his decision is his own. You don't become a Supreme Court justice by being a fool. What should have the left ticked off if they were honest with themselves is that Obama did not convince Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg to retire during the many years that Democrats controlled the Senate. She could easily have stepped aside, she's 85 now. It was a mistake to hold on, and now at her advanced age and with the popularity of President Trump, she may be replaced by another constitutional conservative. She can't sit on the bench forever, her days are numbered and not in the favor of the left. Should that happen and President Trump seats another on the bench, the Supreme Court will turn conservative for a generation or more. Either Obama was too busy being arrogant and partying with celebrities, or he planned poorly for the most important issue out there. He could have possibly guaranteed for liberal votes on the court. I think he believed solidly that Hillary Clinton would become president and it was nothing to stress over. But he could not have been more wrong. Obama's plan to turn the controlling voting bloc in America Marxist by utilizing an open borders policy is also failing. His dream of permanent Marxism in the U.S. is all but D asterisk asterisk D. We really dodged a bullet on that one. Trending, justice served. Maxine Waters busted, formal investigation underway now as for Obama himself, he bought his own press. He really thought Americans supported his anti-business, anti-capitalist agenda. What they really wanted were jobs and security and he never figured that out. His first hint was the beating the Dems took in the midterms in 2010. But he still believed he could do no wrong. Fox News points out the obvious progression of events here, as Mara Liasson wrote for NPR in 2016, during Obama's 8 years in office, the Democrats have lost more House, Senate, state legislative and governor seats than under any other president. She noted that the Obama legacy includes one huge failure, a diminished Democratic Party. In 2013, then-Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid, DNEV, invoked the so-called nuclear option, discarding traditional filibuster protections for the minority party in favor of requiring only a simple majority to approve judicial and executive branch nominees. He carved out an exception for people put forward for the Supreme Court. The next year, with CNN describing President Obama as an unpopular president limping through his second term, Republicans reclaimed control of the Senate. As a result of that achievement, President Obama's chances of securing a liberal majority on the High Court all but disappeared. In the spring of 2016, Senate Republicans blocked a vote on Judge Merrick Garland, who President Obama nominated to the Supreme Court following the D**H of Justice Antonin Scalia. The Republicans said the looming election should allow Americans to decide which party's president could appoint the next Supreme Court justice. Last year, with partisanship riding high in the Senate, Republicans extended Reid's majority rule provision to include Supreme Court justices, clearing the path for confirming Judge Neil Gorsuch to become a Supreme Court justice. President Trump's pick to take Justice Kennedy's place will have to win a majority of Senate votes, which is no mean task. But remember that Trump is a master negotiator and deals will be cut here. His Supreme Court pick will get through using the nuclear option, it is a virtual certainty. On top of that, what really has the left wigged out is the possibility of Roe v. Wade, the 1973 Supreme Court decision legalizing abortion nationwide, being overturned. They have totally come unglued over it, and there are a couple of progressive Republicans also in that camp. Three Republican senators, Lisa Murkowski of Alaska, Shelley Moore Capito of West Virginia and Susan Collins of Maine, all have stated they will not vote for a Supreme Court nominee who suggests he or she might not respect the precedent of earlier rulings allowing abortion. John McCain cannot be counted on here either, as he is suffering from terminal brain C*****, so his vote will be absent. This will be tricky, as it only leaves the GOP with a two-vote advantage in the Senate. Either the progressive Republicans get on board, or Trump will have to sway a Dem or two. He's done it before, I have no doubt, he'll do it again. Republicans should purge themselves of RINOs, and this would not be such a life or D*H issue when it comes to crunch time for voting. Regardless, the High Court is moving to the right and will remain there for decades, and there's pretty much nothing the Democrats can do about it. Trump is set to announce his nominee the evening of July 9th. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell, RKI, has made it clear he wants to vote on the new nominee this fall. This will not wait until after the midterms, and the Democrats are now in a panic over it. They can thank Obama for all of this. President Trump has undone most of Obama's damage by lowering taxes and scuttling regulations. The economy and jobs are booming, and our military is being rebuilt to keep us safe. Americans are now optimistic about our country's future once again. In President Obama's Deputy National Security Advisor Ben Rhodes' book, The World as It Is, a memoir of the Obama White House, President Obama asks his aides, after Donald Trump's election, what if we were wrong? It was, as the New York Times noted, a moment of rare self-doubt. Perhaps he should have wondered about that long before his term was over. The Dems are blind to the damage Obama caused their party, but they cannot deny the catastrophe the Supreme Court is for them, and only one man led the way on that. Barack Obama. Already, with Gorsuch on board, recent rulings have been devastating for the left. These include Janus v. AFSCME, the American Federation of State, County and Municipal Employees, which could undermine the influence of public employee unions that generally support Democrats in elections, the upholding of President Trump's travel ban on countries that pose a national security risk, and the ruling in favor of a baker who refused to produce a wedding cake for a same-sex couple. These are dark days for Marxists and sunny ones for conservatives. This points to the High Court swinging far to the right in the future and all but ending the leftist hold on America. Next up, the retirement of Justice Ginsburg.